The odds were against these Syrian rebels. Forced to retreat and abandon their strongholds in the north, these fighters have suffered major setbacks over the last few days. But then they launched a sudden counterattack and within hours managed to overrun government positions in al-Nairab. The rebels also shot down a Syrian army helicopter, but they were no match for an army backed by Russian fighter jets. The opposition's military victory was short-lived, and President Bashar al-Assad's troops soon regained control of the town. Although al-Nairab holds no strategic importance, the rebels needed a small victory to reassure the millions of civilians trapped in Idlib that the fight is far from over. But the rebels' gains in al-Nairab were largely due to Turkey's growing involvement in Idlib. The Turkish military has intensified its shelling of Syrian army defense lines in al-Nairab and Saraqib. More Turkish troops are pouring into Idlib, establishing military outposts. Their aim is to prevent Syrian forces from advancing towards the city.
The Syrian regime got what it deserved, but that's not enough. It will pay a heavy price for attacking Turkish soldiers. I will announce the actions to be taken about the Syrian issue after I meet with my parliamentary group tomorrow.
As fighting intensifies, civilians are abandoning their villages. Ariha is a ghost town. Its population of 80,000 has largely left for safer areas. Around 700,000 people have been displaced over the past 2 months as the Syrian army continues its offensive. But the escalation is raising fears of a broader military confrontation. Assad's main ally, Russia, has called on Turkey to stop its artillery attacks. 2 years ago, Russia and Turkey played a crucial role along with Iran in establishing a safe zone in Idlib. The US Syria envoy James Jeffries is expected to meet with senior Turkish officials on Wednesday to discuss the government's offensive in Idlib. The US accuses Iran, Russia, Shia militias and the Syrian government of undermining international efforts to implement a ceasefire that would allow millions of Syrian refugees to return to their homes. Hashem Ahelbarra, Al Jazeera, Istanbul.